So you bought a shiny new phone, and a few months later, you realize it isn't as fast as it used to be. You would have noticed some lag that wasn't there before. This issue isn't just limited to budget phones. Even high-end phones like Samsung Galaxy Note or Apple iPhones are also prone to occasional slowdowns after using it for a few months. But why does this happen? And what can you do to prevent your phone from slowing down? Let's find out. There are a number of possible reasons why your smartphone slows down over time. They can be broadly classified into software-related and hardware-related issues. Let's look at them one by one. One of the major reasons for a slow phone is too many apps running in the background. In fact, many apps like Facebook, Twitter, and Messenger runs in the background and continuously uses the phone's RAM, processor, and mobile data. So when you launch more demanding apps, like games, your phone won't have enough RAM or the processing power to run smoothly. This eventually makes your phone look sluggish and slow. The best solution is to uninstall apps that you don't use or just install the light version of the apps like Facebook Lite or Twitter Lite, which consumes less RAM and processing power. The next reason is planned obsolescence, which is the practice of deliberately designing a product so that it doesn't last long. This ensures that customers replace their old products very often, and thereby increasing the sales of newer models, which directly translates into more profit for the product manufacturers. Recently, Apple and Samsung were fined by the Italian antitrust authority for deliberately slowing down old phones by pushing operating system updates. Apple in particular acknowledged that it slowed down older iPhones on purpose to extend their battery life.
Basically, Apple finally came forward and said what many people had suspected for a long time, that when you update to the newest versions of iOS on the following phones, let me just list them for you so you can see if your phone is one of the ones that's affected, the iPhone 6, 6S, SE, and iPhone 7, that they slow your usage down. But Apple says it's not for the reason that many are accusing them of.
So you might think that the best way to avoid this is to not install operating system updates. But think again, operating system updates usually don't come alone. They also come with security patches, which is essential for the security of your phone. So the only way to avoid this is to buy phones from manufacturers with a history of not slowing down older phones. The next major cause for a slow phone is full internal storage. Your internal storage becomes fragmented after several cycles of read and write. Reading and writing data into a fragmented internal storage takes time. But when you maintain your internal storage near full capacity, the time required to read and write data increases drastically, which further slows down your phone. Here is an example of storage performance comparison in OnePlus 3T just out of box versus after a year of usage. You can clearly see how the read and write speeds have reduced after just 1 year of use. The best way to avoid this is to maintain your internal storage under 80% of its total capacity. That is, if you have a 32GB of internal storage, try to maintain at least 7GB of free space. So, remove any unwanted photos, videos, or apps from your phones. Also, app cache files can consume quite a bit of storage space if allowed to grow unchecked. So, clearing cache files can free up storage space and make your phone perform better. The next reason is app updates. This might not seem like a big reason, but think about it. Usually, when new apps are launched, they are specialized in doing one or two things. But as time passes by, they add more and more features to make the app look feature-rich. So after a couple of updates, the app will use more RAM and CPU than it did before, but your hardware still stays the same, so performance feels slower. Take an example of WhatsApp. 3 years ago, it had way less features than today. There was no status updates, group video calls, or Snapchat-style image editing. So WhatsApp would have run smoothly on a budget phone 3 years ago. But today, with these added features, the same phone will run much slower. The best solution is finding a similar app which is not as bloated or filled with unnecessary features. You can even find older versions of an app, but just make sure they have no security holes. So in conclusion, the best way to speed up your phone is to just factory reset your phone and install only the apps that you use and maintain your internal storage at 80% of its total capacity. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to TechTaters for more videos like this.